Okay guys, in this video I'm going to show you how you can find the equation of the least squares regression line for the data using a Casio scientific calculator. Okay, let's say you are given this information and they want you to find the equation of the least square regression line for the data. Okay, the table below represents the distance in meters required by a car to apply brakes and reach a standstill when it is traveling at a given speed. Okay, you have the speed there and you have the braking distance. So whether the question is given this way or this way, they still want you to find the same thing. So they can say, find the equation of the least square regression line for the data, or find the equation of the line of best fit for the data. It's still the same thing. So this is the solution to this question. Now we are going to use a calculator to see how you can find this solution using a Casio scientific calculator. Okay, let's get our calculator. So let's say you are using this calculator or this one. The process is still the same. If you are using this calculator or this one, the process is still the same. Okay, now what you want to do is to press mode. If you have this calculator, you press mode, there is mode. If you have this calculator, there is your mode. So you start by pressing mode. And then now what you want to do is to choose start. Can you see start in this calculator is number 2. So you have to choose option 2. And in this calculator, you have start, which is option 3. So you have to choose option 3. So you choose option 3 to get start in this calculator. And then you choose option 2 to get start in this calculator. And from now on, the process is the same. Let me use just one calculator. I can close this one. Okay. So if you have the other calculator or this one, you just have to follow the process I'm going to do now. So now you want to choose what? Option 2. Can you see in option 2 you have A plus BX? A plus BX. So this is the equation they're asking you. The equation of the least square regression line. It is in this form, A plus BX. So you choose 2. And then now you have the table. So if you are using the other calculator, just follow the process as I'm doing it. The process is still the same. Okay, now what you want to do is to insert these values. These are your X and these are your Y. Let's insert the X first. So you start with 20. You press equal to insert it. And then 40. You press equal to insert it. And then you have 60. And then you have 80. And then you have 100. And then you have 120. And then you have 140. Okay, we are done inserting the X. Now let's insert the Y. So you shift this side by pressing this button and then you go up. So 20 goes together with 6. So you make sure you insert it the same way as it is in the table. 20 goes with 6. So you have to get 6 there. So you insert 6 and then you press equal. There's 6. You can see 20 goes together with 6. And then you have 16. So you have to respect the order, right? And then now you have 30. And then you have 48. And then you have 70. And then you have 80. And then you have 110. Okay, you are done inserting all the values. Now what you want to do is to press AC. There's AC. And then you go and press shift. And then you press start. You can see start above 1. You can see. So you choose 1. And then from here you have to press reg, which is option 5. So you press 5. And then now you can get the values of A and B. So to get the value of A, you press 1. So you press 1 and then you press equal. So this is the value of A. You can see it's negative 17.14. There's A, negative 17.14. Now, if you want to get the value of B, you go back and press AC. And then you press shift again. You press start, which is above 1. And then you choose again reg, which is option 5. And then now you choose B, which is option 2. And then you press equal to get the value of B. You can see the value of B is 0.86 to 2 decimal places. You can see 0.86. And then you just have to plug the values inside the equation, and then you have the equation. So you can write it this way if you want, by having this one first and this one follows after. Okay, so this is how you find the equation of the least squares regression line for the data using a Casio scientific calculator. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to subscribe and activate the notification bell so that you can be notified every time I post new content for you. As for now, see you next time and take care.